So does it feel hard being white? Do you ever wish I wasn't white?
Sometimes I think that, like, if I was black or if I was Hispanic, not so much Asian, but it'd be easier. Like, I'd be able to get away with saying things, you know, that I can't necessarily. I mean, I kind of get that because I am a girl, I am a woman, so it's a lot easier to say things.
Right.
But I think that I kind of, in a way, feel bad for them because I think that they go through our school system, at least at our school, and they don't really, like, learn how to interact with people in a way
right.
that's not based on race, in a way
yeah.
that's not, you know, just, like, talking to someone and listening to their ideas and being exposed to different ideas rather than, you know, oh, she's white, you know, whatever she says is internalized oppression, you know, and it's just, like, that kind of just stupid, and
yeah.
I think that's the main problem.
Well, because when you're saying I wish I wasn't, I do remember, because when I was in middle school, you know the bar and bat mitzvahs?
Yes.
Yeah, so I remember going to those, and I did feel a kind of, and with friends of other, because I've always had a lot of friends of various, like, you know, I always go to Nowruz, which is the Iranian New Year.
Oh, okay.
I always celebrate that. So I'm with my friends at their cultural celebrations, and I'm like, wow, you have like a really strong sense of, you know who you are. Like, you know
right.
what you're, and I think this is the positive way to express identity, that you know who your ancestors were, you know what your cultural traditions are, and you kind of, you associate with that, and that's a part of who you are. Because I think for a lot of European Christian Americans, you know, we don't have a strong sense of cultural
yeah,
identity. Like,
I can tell.
We don't have these traditions that we feel attached to. Like other groups, like, say, you know, Iranian Americans or Jewish Americans, that they do have a really strong sense of community
and why
identity.
Don't you have it? Are you forbidden to have that, or why don't you have it?
Well, I think there are definitely people that are opposed to European Americans
yeah.
having, but I think at the end of the day, if we wanted to, we could have it.
Oh, okay.
It's, I think, at the end of the, in a sense, we are kind of our own worst enemy, because we kind of choose to abide by these rules. We say, oh, okay, we won't say this, we won't do that. So, you know, if we want to embrace identity and culture, we can. It's up to us to.
So is it because whites are feeling guilty about the plight of minorities or people of color, whatever they call them? Is it, do whites feel guilty about what they having to go through?
I think that's what we're told. I would say that.
Well, because yeah. I think there's a lot of guilt.
Yeah.
Ultimately, because I felt white guilt before. I remember there were, you know, earlier on, you know, before Trump in 2016. You know, that I felt that I owed something
yeah.
to other people because of what, you know, my ancestors did or didn't do. But at a certain point, you kind of realize, that, okay, like, everyone's done bad things, more or less.
That's right.
You know, and we didn't do any of those
That's
things.
Right.
You know, so you kind of say, I don't want to play by that game anymore. And you notice that a lot of times when you do concede something, it... Because I noticed that whenever I would try to be, I guess, like an ally, I suppose, I would still find a lot of hostility.
Yes.
That I wasn't doing enough. And
yeah.
then at a certain point, it's like, what else can I do? It seems that...
They want blood.
I think being a different race other than white is like a benefit for every other type of person except for people who are white. But it's not... I mean, there's some benefits, I guess, to being white, as with every race. But I think, like, the college admissions process is a perfect example of that. Like, you know, you can't really sit there and say that it's easier to be white applying to college. No, it's not. It's
right.
a lot easier to be a minority.
Yeah.
So, you know, you see, like, in college, you see the videos of these, you know, like, white dudes standing up and they're like, you know, hi, I understand that I come from privilege and that what I'm saying is internalized misogyny and white supremacy, so I apologize. And then they, like, sit down.
Oh,
and
that's
like,
terrible.
Done.
I hate it when I do.
Well, and it's like,
I want to slap white people for doing that.
When,
would that be considered a hate crime?
Probably.
No, probably
not toward a white person, no.